Thank you so much. Our program is going to roll out right now. Just before we pause for a prayer, Elder Tebs is going to lead in a song that will lead us to next activities. Elder Tebs, please take stage.
Good morning. I don't know whether you know the song 5 to 6. Can we sing that song, 5 to 6? Ellen, can we project the song, or is it not possible? Okay, let's sing 5 to 6. I think many will know the song.
Just before the bride walks in, we will respectfully ask all people using all different types of cameras to at least please keep them aside. Your lights are interfering because we are live on YouTube as we are doing this. So they are interfering with the signals and the lights are not really good for the occasion. Please. Can somebody out there give Molulu worship, please? We didn't hear that. Thank you so much. At this moment, I'm going to ask the whole congregation to rise as we give honor and respect to our bride.
It's always been a mystery. Two hearts can come together, and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come. When God sends a perfect one, now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure.
Now sit. Thank you, may the congregation now sit.
I'll let
I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I, Ayanda's Chata, give my daughter Ayanda in marriage.
Amen. Thank you, my father. I thought you forgot your line, but thank you so much. God bless you. You may be seated.
Please,
another illumination after that. Thank you. Thank you so much. Is everything okay here? Great. Thank you so much. The program has started. We have officially opened. We would love to extend our hearty welcome to everyone who has come this morning to join us in this ceremony, the wedding of our own bachelor from Denmark South, Neil Foxen, and our own bachelorette, well, all the English they'll say maiden, from Vendruk Central SDA Church. Thank you so much, and good luck to both of you for making this decision true today. We have pastors among ourselves. I'll not ask you to stand. We have actually been asking you so much standing since yesterday. We would love to recognize your presence. We have our magistrate. You'll be seeing him as he'll be coming. With him, he has come with his wife. You'll be seeing him as he comes here. We also have, let me single out the chatters. In particular, again, they have come actually all the way from Katima Mulilo to come and join us on this day. And in the same manner and same fashion, let me turn on to the Foxens, who have traveled all the way from Zimbabwe and all other parts of the world to come and join us on this day. You are both more than welcome to the land of the brave in particular, and to Vendruk for the chatters from Katima Muliro. And you are also welcome to Vendruk anyway. And thank you so much. It's the city that is so clean but very expensive. A little plate of food is around 1.5. So enjoy with us. But you will afford because you are in our pockets. Welcome. After having said that, ladies and gentlemen, invited guests, the friends to Neil and friends to Ayanda, the friends and colleagues to the Chatters and the Foxens, please feel at home. Join us on this day as we witness this ceremony that shall be testimony to all of us. To God be the glory. What do you say, church?
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Just before we proceed, some few little things to iron out. We have already said that cameras, let me lower down my voice because it's too hard. Cameras are not allowed. We have official cameras that are surrounding us. You can see at my back, Ray is also there. Please, these are the official cameras that are allowed to move anywhere in this space and all over. As for the phones, the tabs and everything, please just keep them. There'll be so much time for selfies and everything once we are done. You can stand at a distance as usual, then they'll be in the view. You can take some selfies there. Number two, our bathrooms are on my left-hand side. I have deacons and few key people who are on the lookout. They'll be guiding you. Please do not use these entrances. These, the ones that are very close to me, use the one that is far on my left-hand side. the man who is walking Gideon, the chief of staff and chief of protocol. So please, whenever you are stuck, there are so many deacons around, but he'll be there to guide you. And then the entrance where the bride came through, please keep it closed. Do not tamper with it. Always go to my left-hand side. Sorry for that. After having said that, I think you are all welcome to this place, and we have already started our program. Allow me now to introduce to you the two families, in particular, the Chatters and the Foxens. May you, my parents, please stand up. Thank you for standing up. May you one more time again turn around and let the congregation see you. You can remain standing. I should say, Miss Foxen and Miss Chatter, those heads, whether they are heads, I think they are imports. We can't find them in Chinatown, right? So, please, you look so beautiful. Dad, you look so handsome, and thank you so much. My dad, you look so beautiful, and you look so beautiful, Mom, and Dad, you look so handsome. Please, these are the Foxens, the parents to Neil Foxen. And people, these are the Chatters, the parents to Ayanda Chatter. Thank you so much, parents. May you be seated. Allow me also, as I do a few recognitions, you have seen the beautiful boys and girls who walked in this morning. Let me start with the groomsmen so that we do a final grand introduction with the ladies. We had Darlington Dewey, are you still here? Please, your head and your face to the people. Thank you. We have Tabo Chatter. We have Carlos Bryan. And we have Seth Chatter. And to our ladies, we have with us Aletta Chatter. Oh, I thought you're also from UK. Did you come with an alcohol? Thank you so much. We have Miranda Christian. We have Georgina Mutello. And we have Tabitha Chatter. Thank you. Doing all the good job, holding the rings and doing everything today is our maid of honor, our own beautiful Spuel Tivezi. Thank you. And finally is our best man. Are you a brother or a best man? Both. Okay, stand and everyone see you. He's our brother, Nathan Foxen. Thank you so much. I'm not alone in facilitating the program in closure. I have come with me, Pastor Ileka. Please, Pastor. You saw him as he was standing here. And accompanying him and seeing that the bow tie is seated very well was our sister, Neliswa. Where are you seated, Sisi? Thank you so much. Please, your face to the people. Thank you so much. I should let you know that we are counting down to a similar ceremony to the two. What do you say, Church? Thank you. I'm also with my Elder Pazwa, who is standing in for Elder Munyungano. Please, my Elder, may you stand up. Thank you so much. You can see the tie is well seated, and that was done by our own sister, Lillian Pazwa. Are you here? There she is at the back. I think you can see her very well. Thank you so much. Moving on, I'll be having our own elder to do the vote of thanks as part of the team, Elder Sankwasa Mubita. I saw him walking around somewhere. Okay, on behalf of him, I'll ask my sister, my patients, wherever you are, I see you to stand wherever she is. Thank you so much. And our closing prayer will be done by our own elder from Veduk Central, Elder Bodrick Mutero. I saw you somewhere. There he is. And standing before you sit down, I'll ask my sister Vasinte also to stand. Look at that mate. Thank you so much. You may be seated. And my name is Brighton Smasiko. I'm not written here, so I'm telling you. I'm Brighton Smasiko. Yeah, I made sure I'm not written here. I'm not a public figure. Great. Thank you so much. Along with me, I've come with my own beautiful wife, a.k.a. Vanina Chuma. She's seated right there. Please stand. Everyone sees you. The dress is so long and so beautiful, so she can't stand so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Let's turn our eyes now to the Lord. Let's start with our opening prayer we have sung, and we invite our elder to come and open with a prayer, and then the program will roll out. Final announcement, which was said already, no cameras. There'll be no people standing here guiding you, but you have to guide yourself. No cameras. Ayanda would have wanted to write with an aeroplane in the sky and say, please, no cameras. So I'm doing it on her behalf. My elder, take us to the throne.
Our heads are bowed. Let us pray. Gracious, loving Father who art above, we come before your throne of grace, asking for forgiveness and thanking you for life, thanking you for this gathering, thanking you, Lord, for the two parents who raised the two who we have come to witness. We want to thank you especially for the two who are being married today, as we have come to witness. Lord, as you stated in the beginning, you instituted marriage, and Lord, you said Neil is going to leave his father and mother and be enjoined to Ayanda, and the two shall become one flesh. Lord, we pray that nothing should separate them, as you are the rock of ages, the foundation upon which this marriage is going to be set. For you say in your word, unless the builders work with the Lord, their work, they labor in vain. Lord, how we pray that this marriage may be yet another testimony for your work, for your witnessing in this world. Let this house, let this church that you are building today be a church where even many will be saved. How we pray, Lord, that this marriage will be an honorable marriage. How we pray, Lord, that the bed you are going to set from today will be undefiled. Bless them abundantly. We present, Lord, in a special way, that in this home which you are setting, may there be true wine, wine of joy, wine of companionship, wine of love, wine that will have hospitality. We bless you, Lord. We thank you. And Lord, as we are going through the proceedings, may you be ahead of everyone. As they go into their marriage, Lord, may you be the one who will instruct them and counsel them day in, day out. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for we have thanked you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
be but a ghost, searching for that open door. Winter storm has come and darkened my life, seeking to rise no more. On earth can I turn to? I look to you.
Neil, Ayanda, can you please stand? Thank you very much. Looking very handsome, my friend. God bless you. And you too, dear. Looking very lovely. I can just imagine all the ladies thinking, that's the dress I want. But please, copyright, ne? You cannot wear the same dress to your wedding, please. All right. Dear friends,
It is indeed a privilege and honor for me to be standing in the presence of God and also in the presence of you as witnesses and these two lovely couple. We are standing here recognizing that the sovereign God, the Holy One, is here with us. Because this, what we are about to do and what we are busy with, is ordained and it is sanctioned by God Himself. And therefore, if this was not church, I was going to jump of excitement and joy that as ministers and leaders of the church, when people follow what God commands, we need to be very happy. Amen. We need to be excited. These are the things that we are looking forward to. And we can but just say thank you, Jesus, for bringing you here and bringing you up to this point that you have come here to come and say, my partner, I want to walk with you this journey until Jesus comes or until death do us part. Amen? Amen. And therefore, it gives me great pleasure to say to you, dear friends, that this what you are busy doing, it is sanctioned by God. God is very happy with what you are doing here. And this is what God has established in the Garden of Eden when He said that man shall leave his parents and he shall be joined to his wife, and the two of them are going to become one flesh. They are going to become one flesh. But here are just some few things. Sorry, friends. The Bible says to us in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, that as you follow this very important example from Jesus Christ, it is important that you take the word of God as your advice, as your counsel, as the only authoritative word when it comes to how you are going to walk this journey. But if that is not enough, we are also blessed by Grandmother Ellen White. She wrote a very, very lovely book called Adventist Home. Can I see the hands of those who've got this book in your house, Adventist Home? Yes, a lot of them. You can't see them now, but many have this wonderful book. If you get stuck in the Bible, which I'm sure you are not going to get stuck, because there's so many good things that God has in store for you. And Adventist Home just makes it even more easier. Let me take this opportunity also to thank your marriage counselor, Pastor Franciscus Matamo. Many of the things I'm not going to share with you, you have gone through the counseling session, and I trust and believe that you are continuously going to go through that information so that you are acquainted with what is your responsibility as a group, what is your responsibility as a bride. And therefore, we just want to thank God for using him. And thank you for taking this bold step. We need to really congratulate you. Thank you. It's not an easy thing, especially here in Africa, when you think of all the 10, 15, 30 cows that you need to pay. In some other countries, you need to bring chickens. Ish, but I have not found that place yet. But nonetheless, my woman is here, and I think I'll do anything to get her. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Friends, we are coming to the conclusion of this little sermonet. Allow me just to highlight to you the three very important things of why God has instituted marriage. Genesis chapter 2 from verse 18 to 24. Genesis chapter 2 from 18 to 24. We find these three very important basic points. And these are for you and also to those that are intending to get married, or those that are already in marriage. If you are not following this, it is going to be of very beneficial to you. Number one, God is saying to us that the two of you need to share. But you don't just share anything, you share your love. The love that Jesus Christ has given to you. The love that Jesus Christ has given unto you. This is what you are sharing towards each other. But it doesn't end there. There is also the other basic point, which is support. Neil, you need to support your woman. Ayanda, you need to support your man. The two of you are there to help each other. And then lastly, also very, very important, both of you need to honor each other. You need to respect one another. This is what we find in Genesis chapter 2 from verse 18 to 24. And with these words, I would like to just wish you well, wish you God's blessing, and we trust and believe that He is continuously going to give you a calm spirit as you walk this journey. Yes, it's not going to be easy, but you're doing the right thing, and God is with you. So may God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to ask my friend Nathan just to come a bit closer. And at this moment, we are going to listen to the reciting of vows. And both of them have decided to express themselves from their hearts. So I'm going to start with Neil, the groom. All right. We are going to change. We are going to start. Hey, man, you're a very good husband, man. To be saying my wife first, man. Putting her first. Hallelujah. Yeah. There's another point. Fourth point. Don't forget that. Always put your woman first. All right. Nathan? Yes. And while she's doing that, my friend, please just hold her hand. Eh? You can turn around and look towards each other. And please take your time, dear. You don't need to rush. And if there are tears coming, we are just going to say hallelujah. Because there are tears of joy. You can go ahead. Just hold her hand.
My countdown began 290 days ago. And at the start of it, I thought I knew you well enough to marry you. I thank God for the last 290 days out of the thousands of knowing you. 290 days of eye-opening realization, planning, pinning on pinches, disagreement, tears, and sheer frustration. Because now, on day zero, I can say that I now know you well enough to marry you. And I'm happy to learn more. We've been friends for what seems like the longest forever. But every day with you is different. Every day with you is exciting. And I'm looking forward to more forevers. You'll always be the peanut to my butter, the spring in my step, the blue in my sky, the ivory to this ebony, and the cheese to my macaroni. Because I have found a best friend in you, the one whom my soul loves. Love is an act of endless forgiveness. We're two imperfect people, but we are held by a perfect Savior. Because He said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made strong in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness, Neil, so that Christ's power can rest on me, on you, and on us. Our two lives will move through life together. Our two lives will be the best they can be together. Our two lives will be one forever. I think I need some tissue. For that reason, today I promise to be your companion and your friend, your ally in conflict, your greatest fan and your toughest critic, your comrade in adventure, your student and your teacher, your playmate, your confidant, and your greatest challenge. I promise to love you forever and always, because it's a principle. This is my sacred vow to you, Neil. With love, hashtag the Vixen.
Thank you very much, Ayanda. Neil, this is your time now to show your commitment through the vows. This is very nice. Where's my water?
The big speech I prepared has disappeared after what you said to me, Ayanda. I've always found it easier to sing in such situations, and so today I'm going to sing for you.
Someone like you would
My best friend, who would have thought that we're good at counting, so we keep counting these days. Who would have thought that 6 years and 65 days later, we would be right here, brought back to the exact same place where this whole story began, just outside. Don't say where, but outside. God has been good to me. Please hold this so I can hold it. God has been good to me, and today His goodness stands before me, and all I can say is, you are flesh of my flesh. And bone of my bone. Others may try and separate us, but they don't stand a chance. Because nowhere else on this earth is there anyone like you. I thought this would be the easier part. I'm almost done. Ayanda, you are flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. And we are one. So today, before men, angels, and God Himself, I vow to love you, to care for you, to provide for you, to entertain you, and to support you. Amen.
Beautiful. God bless you, Neil. God bless you, Ayanda. At this moment, ladies and gentlemen, you see here on my left, we have our best man, the brother Nathan. You can start giving Neil the ring. And please take your time, my friend. You hold her nicely, her hand, so that the camera can take nice photos. This is a token of your affection, your love. Saying, this is my woman for life. Very much. God bless you, friends. Yes, omake, omake. Thank you for being patient with us. We do not hold you accountable for the tears and for everything that you have done, which might seem to be inappropriate. We thank God because it's just part and parcel of your response and your deep emotions towards each other. God bless you very much. Please move with me to the table. round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Mr. Andre. We are going to ask the couple just to turn around, and we are going to ask the parents to join us here so that we can just perform the ceremony of the Unity Send. So we'll just ask the parents to slowly make their way up here, both the Foxen family as well as the Chatters. This is just to say, dear God, we are grateful for what you have done. You have united these two people, but we are also asking you to unite us as families. And therefore, we are just going to ask them to... Thank you very much. You can join them beside for a nice photo session. Guide us through this process. First, Neil and Ayanda, they're going to pour some sand into the bottle to indicate that they agree with this ceremony, to say, dear God, we want to be united as husband and wife, as man and woman. I think that's sufficient. And now we are going to ask the family to each pour inside the holder, symbolizing the unity between the families which has been established by God. Because of the two couple that have joined us. Thank you very much. That is more than enough. Thank you. You may take your seats, families. Foxens, you may take your seat. Chatters, you may take your seat. Neil and Ayanda, please join me up front here. As we are praying. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for this wonderful opportunity that You have given us to participate in the session between Neil and Ayanda. We thank Thee, dear God, for the institution of marriage, which needs to take place between one male and one female. Dear God, we thank Thee for the example that the two of them have set. From the time that we have started, the vows that they have exchanged, the rings that they have exchanged, the signing of the certificate, dear God, the ceremony of the unity sent between the two families, and now they are seated here in front of you and in front of this congregation. We ask, dear God, that you will continue to bless them. Let their marriage be an example to all of us so that we can know what it means to glorify God. You want them to glorify you. And therefore, we just ask, dear God, that you will bless them and guide them and lead them in a special way. Bless their families as well. And we ask that the support that will be coming from their side the help that they will give will continue to build these two so that they can really be a success in their marriage. All of this we ask and we thank thee in Jesus' name. Amen. Neil and Ayanda, I'm going to ask you to stand as you face the congregation. Dear friends, Neil reminded me very early this morning, Pastor, please don't forget the kissing part. And so, there is no way that I'm going to forget, my friend, so please get ready. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you, as a minister of the gospel, and whilst that is happening, hallelujah, Omake. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Yes, we should be excited. We should be excited. I present to you Mr. Neil and Mrs. Ayanda Foxen. My friend, you can kiss your hand.
Not end there. Another luation and a round of applause. Thank you. Can I hear everyone saying wow?
Wow.
One more time?
Wow.
Ayanda, that was for you. Thank you so much. We are still streaming live right here in Vendook Central SDA Church. We have made sure that the program is kept short to the point and releases you to go and change your outfits for the next session. I checked my moms and dads. Well, Mom Foxen, Mom Chata, please remember to carry on flat shoes, because the next session that is going to come, that will be at the country club, it's gonna be dancing. We want to see you dancing. So is everyone. Right at this time, please allow me to give another little surprise to Ayanda in particular, Miss Foxen. That sounds strange, eh? Miss Foxen. Oh yeah, she does this. Friends to Neil, the Restoration Quartet, where are you? A round of applause to them, please.
Today is the day when Ayanda says, I do.
As they make their way to their seats, another round of applause. Thank you so much to our visitors, the Restoration Quartet that sang is the quartet where Mr. Foxen sings. I nearly said our groom. That thing is of the past now, please. It's now Mr. and Miss Foxen. We are very thankful, and I should say to the young people who are watching, Ish, the bar was a bit high. But you can still beat that with time, right? Please, to all those who are planning, we are here to support you. Do something. Pastor Eleka is here. Everyone is here. The elders are all over waiting to pray. So please, they are thirsty for that. We are very thankful. At this moment, please, Ms. Mubita and Ms. Mutelo, can you release Elder Mutelo and Elder Sampasa? I mean Elder Mubita, to come and close for us. In particular, Elder Mutelo, please come and pray for us. And Elder Mubita, come and give us a vote of thanks. This marks the end of our wedding ceremony right in the church. Beyond this, I'm going to give you announcements after the two have presented. A round of applause to our elders for the Center.
Is it afternoon? Good afternoon. Afternoon. Thank you. My duty is the easiest of them all. To begin with, we would want to thank the Almighty God for the two lives He has given unto us, for bringing us here as well in good health. He has kept us. And He has made us bear witness to the union of the new foxes. Before, I need also to mention that we will be thanking others at the other side. Therefore, if you seem as if we have not covered you now, We will do so appropriately when you have finished your task. So at this time, allow me to thank those that we deemed they need to be thanked now. On behalf of the Charters, the Foxens, and the church family, it is my honor also to give this vote of thanks. More so also on behalf of my family, it is indeed also a special occasion.
I would not jump to say when I will look at ourselves too, getting married some 16 years ago, present were Mr. and Mrs. Charter. Mrs. Charter was, in fact, the matron at our wedding. And even better, Ayanda Foxen was the flower girl at our wedding. What pleases me even better also is that two of those that are in the bridal party were also part of that wedding. And this really makes me happy to see the one that had a little dress, white dress, today being the main person here. Therefore, allow me to seize that and thank first and foremost the Minister of the Gospel present with us, who officiated at this occasion, Pastor Ileka. Thank you, Pastor. And be always available because we call you often. Also, allow me to extend our appreciation to our esteemed magistrate, Mr. Matulek. Forgive me if I mispronounce the name. We greatly appreciate your presence to come and grace this occasion and formalize it under the laws of the Republic. Thank you, Magistrate. And Madam, we are honored to have you as well. Allow me also to thank our very best MC, Mr.
Please.
Mr. Brighton Simasiku and Madam, thank you also for availing him. And to all others, he said others are available. I should say he's also available to be the MC at your wedding as well. Allow me also to extend our appreciation to those that were responsible to beautify our place, that is Rafik Dego Company. I would want to see them so that others can approach you. Where are the Monica and Tia? Are you around? They have left the place to ourselves. We thank them in absentia. We also want to extend, and we will thank them again, our words of gratitude to the photographers and videographer, Heidi and Tim, and the Nyama Pandas. May we also see, where are you? Oh yes, just wave your hand. Thank you very much. We highly appreciate your services. Allow me also, and I'll thank them again, to thank the bridal team. It has been wonderful to have you here. And of course, you are next. But above all, allow me to thank the matron, Auntie Sipiwe Masarira. You are doing extremely well, and we are grateful. Thank you. Also, our most important are the guests that have come to grace this occasion, and I will myself ask you to give a round of applause for everyone present here. Without you, this place would have been very cold. Just imagine the empty chairs with no one to ululate, with no one to give smiles and show the beauty or beautify this place with your presence. We greatly appreciate your presence. As protocol, allow me to thank the presence of the Minister of the Gospel, also present here, who is a leader in this church at a higher organization. I recognize the presence of Pastor Peter Maligudu. Thank you, Pastor. And Madam, we recognize and appreciate your presence. Above all, we have special guests, but I'm going to enumerate them properly at the other occasion, for I know they will be present there. Allow me to end it here, and or pause it here, and continue with it on the other venue. Thank you very much to those that have brought us here, Neil and Ayanda Fox.
After all is said and done, let us seek the Lord's face. Our gracious and loving Father, you who caused Adam to go to sleep and provided him with Eve, we can testify this day that indeed you caused Neil to go to sleep, and when he woke up from such a sleep, he beheld Ayanda. And today we witness this beautiful work. We want to thank you and honor you for that. God, as they have started a new journey together, how we pray that you shall pave the way and all snares will be taken out so that they walk a happy walk. Bless all that they will do together as a couple. Bless their home to be. Bless even the womb so that we see the small foxes running around. We want to give glory unto you, for you know the future, as you have already piloted their way into their marriage. Bless the families that were here. We want to praise you again for everything that have happened and that is yet to take place. Thank you. Let your guidance be felt and be seen. And let glory rest upon your throne, for you deserve it. Amen.
Thank you very much. For those that are in the know, they might realize I also belong to this church. So I'll be scared and probably more careful to thank those that are outside and even forget to thank the church because I'm part of the church. I did not mention Vinod Central Church members. The deaconry department, we heartily thank you for hosting us and also for the work that you have done. And also, I forgot to thank Windhoek South. We highly appreciate your presence and your intervention in this whole matter. Thank you once again.
So much, a round of applause to our elders, please.
Thank
Thank you. If you check your time, it's exactly 12:40, and we have agreed to finish at 12:45. So we are done 5 minutes ahead of our schedule. What do you say to that, please? Thank you so much. From here, a few announcements and directions for you. We will be going for the photo station right from here. This is only for the family members and those who are invited. The rest of us, there's quite very ample grounds here. We can do selfies and everything. The procession to the photo station is for the invited and only the family members. Number two, the reception is going to be at 6:00 p.m. 6:00 p.m. It's now 12:41, so we have more than 4 hours or 5 hours to go and prepare. Having said that, the reception is strictly by invitation. If you received a card and you have some few engagements to go to, please quickly pass on the card to those who are interested in going. I announced earlier, a plate in Vendo is very expensive. You don't turn up, it's close to about $2,000-$3,000 wasted. So please turn up. Now, I'll repeat that. The reception is strictly by invitation. There were cards given. You use the cards to go to the reception. The venue will be at Country Club. That is along the Western Bypass. I guess it's a very familiar place to our visitors. We will help you to guide you there. Number three, allow me to brief you on the manner of, or the fashion of exit from here. As I told you, we are streaming live to the whole world as we speak now. So we would love a kind of a pattern as we go out. We will allow our bride, do we still have a bride? Yes, this side. We will allow Mr. and Miss Foxen, Miss Foxen. This time around you can see where you are going, right? You came in with a fare. We'll allow them to move first. The rest, they know how they are going to move. That's the flower girls, everyone. We have already arranged that. I cannot go through the list now. The entire congregation, Chief of Protocol, you are here. Please stand up one more time. They have seen you already, but one more time. He will be guiding us how we move using the two directions. There are other deacons, and there are other deacons, so not deaconesses, but there are other deacons who are going to be guiding us. So you will all, from all angles, go this side so that our streaming remains in the same fashion and same pattern as we came in. Well, after I've said that, please, a round of applause. Great. As we exit, to everyone who has come, whether invited or not invited at the reception, there will be quite an ample lots of refreshments that are outside. So please do not go home and leave us with this food. We can't finish them. Please, we beg you. Let's go and drink together. There will be deacons and this way. We have been saying deacons and deaconesses. They are now all deacons. There will be deacons guiding us outside. So please just follow through. They'll catch up with you. You can also catch up on all old stories. Thank you so much for being with us. God bless you all.